Hi and welcome back to my channel. Now in this video I'm just going over a couple of screwdriver sets. Now I've had this set for about a 12 month now, it might actually be a year and a half. But I just want to show you the difference on what you can spend. So you're watching this video and you're probably wondering, is it worth paying the extra money for a Festool set? Now you know I'm a Festool fan. But I also love Wera tools as well. They're an awesome screwdriver set. Now these Weras I've had for about 8 years. They're still great. They still work. They don't round off or nothing. They're a great screwdriver. These are the laser tip version. I've had them for about 8 years, I think, if I can remember right. But I've just picked up a new set of Weras now. These are the new chisel through screwdriver set. They're a nice set. You get the 13 screwdrivers. They cost about 70 quid. There's loads in there. You've got the metal tops as well for tapping the screws to shock them, to undo them. They are a nice set. I'll just grab these out of the box now and put them on the table. The video ain't about showing off, look what I got, blah, blah, blah. It's about you making a purchase, basically. So if you're thinking of investing, obviously this Festool set is way over 100 quid, right? Now what you get in this set is you do get a little sparky screwdriver, all right? You get your slotteds, you get your Torx, and you get your PZ ones and your PH ones. But you only get a PZ one, all right? A PZ2, a PH one, a PH2. You get Torx 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30, and you get two slotted, a 3mm and a 5.5mm in this set, all right? It is missing a PZ3 and a PH3 as well. But this Wera set, you do get the PH3 and you do get the PZ3, right? And you also get your four slotted, but there is only two Torx. So this set, I'd say, would suit more of a kitchen fitter, all right? Because you do get the more Torx, and obviously when fitting kitchens, you're obviously going to be using some Torx screwdrivers. But the bonus part about owning this set, right, by Festool, obviously, as we know, you get a second lot under here. And under there, you've got a set of spanners, right? You've got 8mm, 10mm, 13, 17 and 19. They are a well-made set of spanners. You've got the ratchet, right, which is nice. It looks nice. They are well-finished on you, these spanners. But there are better sets out there on the market. This is just a part of a set. You also get Allen keys in this set, all right? They're not a bad set of Allen keys. I do use them. And you also get the Festool spanner. Now, I don't know how good it is. I haven't really used it. Doesn't feel the best, all right? I like Bacho spanners. I also like the Wera Jokers, which I put a video on earlier, a couple of days ago. But it's not a bad spanner. It's all right. It feels good. But obviously this video is about screwdrivers, yeah? So back to the screwdrivers now. Obviously with the Weras, all right, let me just try and get that in focus for you. Obviously a Wera's got a nice grip, all right? They are a lovely screwdriver to use. They're very flared around here, so when holding it, you've got a good grip and the screwdriver doesn't seem to spin in your hand. Festool, what have they come up with on their screwdrivers? Now I'll zoom in on this to show you. You've also got the hex as well around the top. Obviously if you want to use your spanner to unloosen. It is a very small hex, mind. There's more of a hex on the actual Wera. But the hex is metal on the Weras, alright? On the Festool, this is plastic. So you are going to round that off if you're using it. Festool should have gone with metal around there. I don't know how far the blade goes into the screwdriver as well. So I couldn't say, I wouldn't be using these in my day-to-day work. I'd be using these in a workshop. This is more of a workshop tool, I would say. But these handles are right with the Festool. They got this, like a memory foam in them. So they're very soft when you're holding them. They are nice to hold. They're very comfy. But the Wera, I think the handle design is better. They're more flared. When holding a screwdriver, it seems to fit nice just in your hand up here when using it. The Festool, not so good. But these haven't let me down. They are a good screwdriver. I've taken the piece off you now. I don't know what I've done with that. Or maybe it's over there somewhere. But yeah, all in all, not a bad set. If you want to pay the extra bucks, obviously you get it in the sustainer and everything. and you can obviously lock all your tools together. But if you want to spend a bit less and have a quality screwdriver set, I recommend going with the Weras, because these do last. They're a great screwdriver, all right? They've never let me down, these Weras, and I do like them a lot. But obviously, once you're doing your kitchen fitting, or you're doing your machining and your woodworking and everything like that, it's nice to bring this set in as a part of your Festool gear. And obviously, with the Wera, you haven't got a case to put them in. So you'd have to invest in another sustainer, some shadow foam to put in there, so you can line all your screwdrivers up to keep them nice, neat and tidy in the shadow foam. But what Wera do supply with the screwdrivers is you can screw these to the back door of your van or somewhere in your workshop, so you can pop your screwdrivers in there and store them nice, neat and tidy. But I do know Wera as well to sell the actual foams, and they're all pre-cut, so you can put all your screwdrivers in the foams, but I'm not 100% if they will fit in a sustainer. Maybe Wera should start making sustainers, that'd be great. But like I said, there's a big price difference on these. You can buy this set for 70 quid. This is 100 plus. I think I paid about 160 quid for this set. But it does come in a case. It is very neat and tidy. It doesn't take up a lot of space. And it's still a good set of screwdrivers. But like I said, the hex on the top of the Festool is plastic. I can't see it lasting. Old school Wera's mind. These haven't got the hex. They're not designed for doing that sort of work. These are laser tipped. Built to last, basically. These are for tapping on the top of the armour with a chisel through drill. They're called chisel through, but I will say, mind, on the box it states these are not to be used as a chisel. So I'll do a couple of zoom ins on the video to show you now. Alright, we'll go ahead and do that because this ain't zooming in right now. And I will show you that, look, see, if you can read that, do not use as a pry bar or chisel. That's all these are for, is for tapping with a hammer to shock the screw to get the screw out of there. So this is the close-up of the set now, because obviously a lot of that video that I've been doing, we have been yapping in distance. So this is what you actually get in the set. I mentioned earlier on the video all the sizes of the screwdrivers you get. And I did show you on the video, I didn't show you tidy. See, we've got the hex on the top of the screwdriver. Now that is plastic. Now this is the foam on the screwdriver, look, watch it now. I don't know, I'm trying to get a side on view to show you. See that? It's like a memory foam. It is nice. I've never seen that in a screwdriver before. It's something Festool will come up with, I think. I'm not 100% on that. Mine don't, you know what I mean, don't take my word for it. But, like I said, it's got a nice foamy feeling to it. I don't know if you can see that tight. Let me get the bigger one so you can see it now. On the side, look, watch this. See, it's very spongy. See that moving in and out? So that's the grip on there. And obviously with the Wera grips then, obviously you've got a nice flared bit by here on the screwdriver. And each of these little yellow pieces, are like, they're like a rubber. And they do last. Like I said, this is 8 year old. And that's what state that's in for 8 years, which isn't bad really, is it? It's still a really good screwdriver and it still takes the screws out as it should. So I'm hoping to get 8-10 years out of these ones as well. Don't know how long the first tool will last, but like I said, they only get used on kitchen fitting and that's it. So let's just go to the bottom of the box now. I'm trying to hold the camera while showing you. In the bottom of the box, obviously, we've got all our spanners. Like I said, they're a nice build. They're all right. They're not bad. And I don't use them a lot, so I can't tell you how good they are and how long they last. And obviously, you get your spanner as well. It's a nice spanner, Festool branded, obviously. It's alright, haven't used it. I like a Bacho, I'm not going to lie. And you get your Allen keys. This set was only bought for me personally because I wanted the Festool screwdrivers. And that's it. And that's what it comes in. It comes in a nice sustainer with a plastic see-through lid. And everything else obviously interlocks together because it's Festool sustainer. I found one of my old screwdrivers to show you what I used to buy before I started buying all of these. Now this one is a Stanley Fatmax. You were really good screwdrivers back in the day. I never heard a Wera when I used to buy these. And these are the Stanley Fatmax, if I remember right. But the only thing that used to happen with these, alright, is once you've had this for about 4 years, maybe 5 years, alright, this part of the screwdriver here becomes very, very smooth. So when trying to use it, it starts spinning in your hand. And obviously the tip of the blade starts rounding off. I don't really know why I've kept it, to be honest with you. But it can still be used for the odd screw if something's a bit loose and to pull it out like. But yeah, that's what I used to buy, the Stanley Fat Max. This, like I said, this video's not about showing off. It's about buying something that's going to last. Now, when you're buying these every 4 years, chucking them away and that, like I've said, these are 8 years old and they're still in great nick and they're still taking screws out. They're not rounding screws. They're not doing none of that nonsense. For all I know, I might be doing another video to say in 16 years' time that these are still working great. I don't know how long they last, but I will say they've already done 8 years, so it's worth paying the extra bucks, isn't it? And that is it, basically. Like and subscribe if you want to see more content from me. I know these videos ain't of woodworking at the moment. There's some projects ongoing, so we should be sure to stay tuned and see what else I'm posting on my YouTube. We're obviously trying some new stuff with a couple of lives. They ain't going too great at the moment, but we're going to crack on, and I'll see you on the next video.